Good morning and welcome to the second weekend of this workshop. As I mentioned last time, I'll be speaking to you as per the schedule tomorrow evening in my valedictory address. But I have come here today to announce some details of the application development contest, which I had briefly mentioned in my opening remarks. The decisions that we have taken is, that we'll announce an application development contest. This is open only to the registered participants of this particular workshop. People who have registered and who are not just enrolled but registered, confirm their registration on the Moodle, and those who will be submitting their feedback as is required by the workshop. Incidentally, although I had announced that we are conducting this workshop under the continuing education program of IIT Bombay, I have briefly spoken to the officials of Indian Society for Technical Education, ISTE, and it is quite likely that ISTE president would agree to issue certificates under ISTE logo as well for the students who are participating in this workshop. So coming back to this application development contest, it's a team assignment. We believe that the team assignment is best done by a small group of two students. However, in exceptional circumstances, a team may consist of three people. So ordinarily, two participants, maximum three. The time limit for submission of this assignment is 1 month. After completion of this workshop tomorrow, so 3rd March is the date tomorrow. The last date for submission, the contest ends on 3rd April. A detailed notification will be posted on Moodle, which will describe what exactly needs to be submitted. But effectively, what we want is that every team should use whatever little they have learnt from these 4 days of intensive workshop, learn some more on your own by using the resources which have been already indicated during the workshop, and then pick up some application which you believe that can be completed within 1 month's time by the team that you form. What is important is, immediately after completing the feedback, you should assign the team members to your team and upload that information on a site to which a link will be sent shortly. Pratik Patodi has set up a site. So submit at this point, you do not have to define the specific application that you are developing, and you can choose absolutely any application that you believe is useful. There is only one caveat: the application that you develop should preferably have a significance in and for education of any kind, whether it is primary education using Indian languages or engineering education with which you are familiar, any stream of education. You can develop some animations, you can develop simulations, you can develop any text rendering, absolutely whatever comes to your mind. I am also announcing the awards for the best application developed. There are 3 awards of rupees 5,000, 3,000 and 2,000. Of course, these awards for not individual members but for the entire team. So that top performing team at a center will get rupees 5,000, the next best effort will get 3,000 and the next best effort will get rupees 2,000. These are the team awards. Of course, at centers where the number of participants are very few and the number of teams which are participating are, for example, just 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5, we will not announce 3 prizes for such remote centers. We will take a call on how many submissions are made and accordingly decide how many prizes to be given. We might club some of these remote centers with very small attendance and participation in the contest and announce some rewards across this group of centers. Please remember, all applications that you develop will be released in open source. Those of you who are not familiar with the open source, the particular license that we use is called CC BY. This is the Creative Commons license by attribution. What it means is that whenever you submit your application, the code, the documentation, and the executable, it will always be attributed to you. It is very, very important that when you develop your application, you do not plagiarize. That means you do not just copy somebody else's thing and submit it. It has to be your own work. I emphasize this, it has to be your own work. If it is found perchance that somebody has been tempted to copy somebody else's code or application, then there could be a very severe penalty for such an action by your own institution and by the academic community. So kindly avoid that. This is a contest to test your own creativity, your own hard work, your own ideas and imagination. Of course, you can build upon ideas which are already available and which you have seen, but the implementation has to be entirely your own. So, to just recapitulate quickly, I am announcing an application development contest for all the participants of this workshop. The numbers that I have got vary tremendously. Somebody says 13,000 people, somebody says 18,000 people. Last time there were up to 201 remote centers which were connected. Just some time ago there were only about 120 remote centers which were connected. So I'm not even sure whether all the students who are enrolled are able to see me and listen to me. That's one of the reasons why I have written down this. This will remain recorded and this will be published. And of course, I will be publishing the details in the Moodle by tomorrow. So this is the programming contest. It's a team programming contest. Ordinarily, the team should be of 2 people, but it could be of 3 people in some cases. Each team will develop and submit 1 application for the contest. The best efforts will be awarded by rupees 5,000, 3,000 and 2,000 award for the best application. And of course, there will be a corresponding certification to that effect. All the applications that are submitted, including of course those which win the awards, will be released in open source under Creative Commons by attribution license. What it means is that your application, including the source code, binary, documentation, everything, will be available for common use by anybody in the country, or for that matter, anybody in the world. But of course, anybody who uses your application or further develops it, because that is what is permitted under open source license, we'll have to always acknowledge that the original application was developed by such and such set of people forming this team from this center. Thank you very much. All the best.